बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। फॉर क्लास सिक्स कंप्यूटर साइंस वी वर गोइंग थ्रू चैप्टर नंबर थ्री इन द लैब एक्टिविटीज एंड वी हैड डन द लैब एक्टिविटी नंबर वन एंड टू एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू लैब एक्टिविटी नंबर थ्री। लैब एक्टिविटी नंबर थ्री इज गिवन इन योर books page number 49. You can read the problem statement from there. Problem statement is that the class teacher of class 6 maintains personal details of her students in an Excel worksheet. Part of the worksheet is shown here. She wants to do the following: filter all the records for height greater than 155 centimeters. Filter all the records for weight less than 60 kilograms. Filter all the records of the students whose birthday is in October. Filter all the records of the students with names starting with S. So this is basically an in the lab activity that we are going to perform. Just look at the display very attentively. This is basically the data. It is not that much visible over here. So what I have done, we are going to perform basically our activity on this data. This is the data. And student IDs are there, student name is there. I can increase the width of the column so that you can see over here. Height in centimeter is there. And weights in kilogram is there. So these are the things that we have taken over here. What we can do, we can apply them on this data central align. Name should be left align. And we can apply borders on this data. Okay, what is the task given in the problem statement? Okay, you have to filter some data. So in order to apply the filter, click anywhere in the data. Achha, what I have done that these dates I have taken, you know, when you go to the format option, in the format cell options, there is basically in number data, there is date format. In the date format, this is basically the format that I have taken, 14 March 2012, means 14 is in number, March is in year, and March is in letters, three letters, and then the year is there in the four numbers. So this is the format of the data that I have taken over here. Okay, so this data is given in your book, page number 49. I have developed it to save the time. How we can apply filter on it according to our given requirement? Click anywhere in the data and go to the data option and apply filter. This is filter. When you will click on the filter, you will see that these buttons are there. Basically, these are the filter buttons in order to filter the data. This is the button using which this filter button, using which you can bring this filter button in your data. So we have got this data and we have applied filter on it. Now, the part A is filter all the records for height greater than 155 centimeter. Okay, how we can do this job? If we have to do this, we will click here. We will go to height in centimeter. Na? We will click here and we will go to number filters and we will go to this option greater than. Greater than, and over here I am going to type 155. So those students will appear whose heights are greater than 155 when I will click OK. Or we have already seen these all things in the previous lessons, which are already uploaded in your Google Classroom. When we will say OK, now you can see that only that data is there, which is containing the height in centimeters more than 155. So this is how we can apply this filter. How we can remove this filter? we will go there and we will say select all, so that will be removed. Second part is there, filter all the records of for weight less than 60 kilograms. So this is basically the weight. Now we will go to the number filters, and this time we will go to the less than option, and in the less than I am going to mention 60 now, and we will say okay. So it is going to display this option, which is now showing you the weights in kilograms, which is basically less than 60. This is basically less than 60, and this filter has been applied now. And how we can remove it? We will go there and we can remove this check mark, or we can apply select all. So then this filter will be removed. The third option is there, filter all the records of the student whose birthday is in October. Now this will be applied on the date birth. We will go to this option and we will filter the dates. How we can filter the date? This is very convenient way how we can apply filter on the date option. But over here we can do this job in this way, ke go there and select only October, where October is there, and remove all the check marks from these dates. I am removing from March and January and August. Leave only October, where October is there. When you will leave only October, so you will be able to see that only that data is coming which is containing October. All the rest will not appear in the result. All the rest of the data will not appear in the result. Okay, so how we can remove this filter? We can apply select all and we can say okay. Matlab, we want to display the students who are having their birthday in the month of October. We can do this job in this way as well. Go to date filters option and go to all dates in the period and say October. This is the method. This is another method. Say October. So it will only show you the dates which are there in the month of October. This is how we can do this job. And how we can remove this filter? We can remove this filter quite easily by saying select all, and all data will be displayed. So number D, last point is there, filter all the records of the students whose names are started by S. Very easy. We had discussed it in the lessons. The videos are there in your Google Classroom. Go to this option, text filters. Go to the text filters. Begins with what? Begins with S, whose names are started by S. Okay, so now you will say that you will see that there are only two students who are whose names are being started by S. So in this way we can apply these all filters. I hope you will not face any problem in it. Now come to the next task. This practical is complete. This in the lab activity is complete. Now number four is there, a computer department of a school has allotted usernames to all the students of the class 6 in the form of first name dot last name at elson.org. Can you fill the respective values in the column C of the worksheet? Try to use the flash fill option. Achha. क्या होगा? What will happen over here? We have seen the flash fill in the last lessons, how we can apply the flash fill. First name and last name is given, and over here the given data should come, the email address should come automatically by the use of flash fill. How we can apply this option? How we can do this option? How we can do this job? This is very easy. What I have done, I have developed this data over here. This is basically the data. First name is there, last name is there, and username is there. user ID is there, and I am going to apply on this data all borders. It is now looking better. And now, how we can do this job? Okay, there should be first name dot last name and at elson.org. So in the very first cell, we will have to type it. Just like first name is Shazia. Shazia dot Khurram at elson.org. In the very first column, you will have to type it, and in the next column, when you will type the initial name, it will show you automatically that you can do this. You can select this data in order to apply these options. I did not type, I only type R. Roshne.zafar is coming automatically. And it is also showing you the even the next options automatically. You can create their user IDs by this method. This is called flash fill. Now if I type Tamila, at elson.org. So in this way, you can easily do this job as it is showing you. But I said, just look again. When we type the very first one, just like Shazia.khurram at elson.org, it shows you automatically in for the next records. So you can select all this data automatically, and you can apply these all data automatically. I hope you are able to understand this topic and you will be able to apply these all options. Thank you so much.